go. Hello. Hello, Mr. Harry, Mr. Ryan, how are you today?
Yeah.
Okay, so what's cousin? You know the cousin?
The cousin is your... I'm cousin with Eric.
No, your brother. Okay. Cousin is...
Eric, he's my brother. Right?
Triad of one's uncle or, you know, uncle or aunties. Yeah?
That's...
Uncle or auntie.
Child
and
one's uncle or auntie.
Yeah. So, your auntie, yeah, daddy's sister, yeah, daddy's sister got a child, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, then you are cousin of the kid, okay? Because, do you understand, yeah? Auntie. Look, child of Eric's uncle or auntie, yeah? You got an auntie, yeah? Daddy's sister, yeah?
Is that how you spell auntie?
I don't know. But
I
you
think
know.
You can just say aunt.
Okay, so. Yeah. So you know the concept. Okay, so what's the binary tree? Remember, we haven't talked about binary trees for a while, right? Binary tree. What's binary tree? Binary tree. All right, Ryan, this is an easy question. What's binary tree?
A binary tree is a tree.
Yeah, it's a tree. Yes. Yeah, it's a tree. It's a tree with numbers. Yeah, it only has two. The maximum child number is two, right? It's a graph, actually. It's a graph. It's the
Venn graph.
No, it's not a Venn graph. It's the directed cyclic graph, right?
Yeah, it's
directed cyclic, yeah, because parent points to kids, yeah? And it, okay, so for today, the binary tree doesn't have any kids, or doesn't have any duplicate numbers, right? Right? This is binary tree, right? A binary tree is a DAG, directed acyclic graph, and a parent, the one without a parent is the root. The one with no kids is the children.
This needs
it's
to be
a leaf.
One because it's smaller.
Yeah, it's the leaves. Yeah, these are the leaves.
That's bigger.
This is these are parents of leaves, and this one is the root. Why we call it a tree? Because we put it upside down. It's a tree. Yeah, growing. It's just a tree growing downward. Okay. Okay. Look. If Eric, look, if this is you, Eric, this is Ryan, right? Huh? And this is mommy or daddy, yeah? Mommy or daddy. Let's say daddy. Okay? And daddy's sister.
S.
Yeah, daddy's sister. They got your grandma or grandpa, right? Yeah?
G.
And then that's the kid I'm talking, I was talking, yeah? That's the kid. Yeah, let's call you the kid.
K.
Z, okay. His first name is start with Z, okay.
How do you know?
Let's just know. Come on.
What's his name?
No. Okay.
Why?
So he doesn't have an English name. Okay. So now look, you two are the cousin of him. Okay. So what does it mean? It means that you three has the same level. Okay. What's the level? Depth. 0, 1, 2. Yeah. Remember we talk about the breakfast search. Yeah. Level by level. This we got a new. Three got the same depth, but you two, yeah, you and him, different parents, okay? If it's the same parents, you're brothers. If it's different parents, that's the cousin. That's what the definition is. Okay? Got it? So now...
But
does
it have to be brothers if you're...
Brothers or sister, yeah, sister as well. Cousin also means the, you know, you couldn't, it's you know, it doesn't have to be boys, it can be girls, okay? Yeah. So today we're giving a binary tree with all the unique numbers. So yeah, unique identities for each node. And given two nodes. So tell me whether it's the cousin nodes or not, right? Yeah. So for any kinds of binary trees, we need to think about how to traverse them, right? So what have you learned so far? How to traverse a binary tree? How do you travel the binary tree? Remember? Yeah? Eric, Ryan, anyone?
We can...
I give you this. What? Come on!
Minus FS, minus FS.
What? Start with what? Two kinds of...
Fibonacci.
Some.
What first search? Okay, what's def for search?
Minus.
Yeah. Okay, okay. Def for search, this is a space. Okay, def for search, preference. Okay, so for this example, what's the preference search order? What's the preference search?
G-D-S-E-R-Z.
So level by level. What's the def for search?
G-D-E-R-S-Z.
Okay, so it's Trevor. It's basically, look, this is the node. The def for search can be the most simple, the most intuitive one is you visit the node first and you visit the left and then you visit the right. Okay, so node, that's also called pre-order, right? Because the node comes the first, also pre-order. So how about we can traverse the binary tree and find the value of these two nodes. And then later we can, you see what we can do. We can compare if they are the same level, and if their parents are different, right? Okay, so first of all, we need to store this data. We can store this data in a dictionary, yeah? Dictionary. So let's say, look, all right? Data, we can say like that. Look, what's this curly brace? What does it mean? What are we trying to define here? Curly brace. What's curly brace defined? What's the data structure starting with?
Dictionary.
Where down? Dictionary. Okay. Dictionary. And then we have a list.
Dictionary.com.
Okay. X. Let's say these two values are X and Y. Okay. These two kids. X. And then when the X, I will start with two another one, which is.
Why is supposed to go under?
Level. Level. Let's say the level equals none. Okay. At the beginning, we don't know. And then we have a parent. This is basically key value pair. At the beginning, we don't know. And we try to complete this, right? And then Y as well. The kit Y points to another dictionary, okay, which has the same level, which at the beginning is none. And then parent, again, at the beginning is none, okay? And then we can do the depth search and breadth search to traverse the binary tree. To traverse the binary tree and to find the value of x or y. And if it's x and y, what do? We just fill their level. So in order to traverse the binary tree, what kind of information do we need to carry down the line? Yeah. The level, yeah?
Yeah.
And also what?
The parent.
Where down? Yeah, the level and the parent, yeah? Yeah, got it. Then we can do the depth search. Let's do the depth search here first. Depth search. We given a root, yeah? And then we want to find out if X and Y are cousins. Got it? Mm-hmm. Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. First of all, if not root, then we just return, yeah? Yeah? If we travel to beyond the leaves, then we just return. Okay? Then what? Okay, so this x2 value, we probably pass in and we can define the root without those, yeah? Define. It's probably here. Define find cousin. Check cousin. Okay, check cousin. And then that will be root and then xy. And then we define a depth search, root. If not root, return. And if root of value, now we know this is the root of value, right? Right, and listen to me. In data, right? If it's in data, it means that we either find this current root of value is either x or y, right? Now in this case, we can remember the it's depth, yeah. So we need the depth here, and we also need a parent, yeah. A parent. So look, data. Root of value and then what? Level. We remember the level. Equals level, right? Depth. Let's call it level, okay? Just consistent level. And then look, data. Root of value. What are we trying to do here? Level and what's next?
Level parent.
Parent. We don't know. We find a root. We find a value x or y. Then we need to
equal parent.
Remember the parent. Yeah, equals parent. Where down? Okay, and then now, if do the left, if there's left triad, we need to depth search, yeah? Do the depth search. If they do the left, then what's next? What's the first parameter to travel, to go deeper? If the left tree, then we go through the left tree. And then level should do what? Level should be what? If we go down, level should be what?
Level should be down, depth search.
Level should be plus or minus 1?
Plus.
Plus 1. At the beginning is 0, right? Plus 1. And then parent would be what? I go to the root dot left. What's the parent of root dot left? What's the parent of root dot left? Come on.
Parent.
What's the parent of root dot left? What's the parent of root dot left?
Root
dot
left. Level.
What? Come on. This is the root. What's the parent of root dot left?
Root dot right.
What's the parent of root dot left?
Root dot left.
What is the parent of root dot left?
Root. That's what I literally said.
If root dot right. Okay, root dot right. Depth search one. Come on.
Depth search root.
Root dot y. And then level. What should I
do? Level minus one root.
Where is the minus coming from? I go down. Let the
plus one. Then.
And then what? What's the third parameter? What's the third parameter?
Ow.
What's the third parameter?
The third parameter is.
What's the third parameter? I'm talking about the parent. What's the parent of root dot right?
Root.
Henry Wayne, can you pay attention, please?
I did.
Don't play. Okay, then we can depth search. We can do this depth search. Root zero. Parent is none. Yeah, the parent of the root is none, right? And then after that, we can find out. We need to compare. Okay, let's do this. We need to compare what? Let's do this. Depth search, root, the level is zero, the parent is none. And then we need to return. We need to check what? The x and y, yeah? So data, x, level, needs to be equals to data, y, level, right? And how? And what's the other thing in order for x and y to be cousin?
To be
the level should be the same and what?
And parent what? Should be different.
Okay, so what? How do you write it? Data x n, yeah, n. Data x parent, yeah.
Yeah.
What? Data x parent what?
Data x parent.
What did you just say?
Root. Different.
Different. How do you say different?
Not equal.
Not equal data y. Parent, okay? That's how you check it. Okay, so this is fine, depth search. But one thing about it is that do we have to visit all the nodes in the binary tree? Everyone, one question. Do we have to visit, travel every single node in the binary tree, do we?
No.
No, yeah, why? Why? Because what are we doing here? We try to find the value of x and y, right? We try to find the level and parents of x and y. And as long as we find the levels of x and y, we don't need to travel, right?
Yeah.
Okay? We don't need to travel. So we can add here. We can add here. Yeah, we can add here. If the data x level is not none, and data y level is not none, then we can just return. We don't need to continue, right? Actually, it should be put here. Because these two are going down left and right recursively, that using the depth search. But if we know that we already find out the values of the levels and parents for x and y, we don't need to,
yes!
We don't need to travel, okay? Okay, make sense?
Yeah.
Make sense?
Yeah.
Right.
Yes.
Right. Can you sit there, please? Okay, so what's the time complexity? If there are n number of nodes in a binary tree. If there are n number of nodes in a binary tree, what's the time complexity?
N!
Remember the binary tree, remember, usually it's O. If we want to travel all the nodes, the worst case is
N.
O n. Ryan, I told you not to guess O1 again, okay? Most likely you won't be O1, okay?
Oh yeah.
Okay, can I have this, please? Okay, so now we're going to talk about the buffer search. Okay, we talk about buffer search. This everything is the same, just the different the order we travel. We are traversing the binary tree is different. Okay, and remember what to do when what kind of data structure do we need to use to implement the buffer search? Yeah. What kind of data structure are we using to implement the buffer search? Everyone, any ideas? You know, this kind of thing?
Q.
Yeah, we push it at the end, yeah? We push first in or out?
First in, first out.
It's just the same, yeah? We use the buffer search to traverse all the nodes in the binary tree, and as long as we haven't found the answer for the the parents and levels for both nodes, then we keep expanding the nodes, yeah, doing the buffer search. Okay, so now we use the queue. Q equals DQ, right? What's DQ?
Double ended Q.
We can also use the list, but the problem is that the time complexity to pop the first element from the list is on, right? It's not linear. So we use the DQ. At the beginning, we need to push three things. What are those? We need for each node, we need to remember three things. The level, probably not level, but let's say root, parent, num, and then level, okay? Level is zero. Okay. While len q, while there's element in the q, so while element in the q, so we can, there are the two ways of doing it. One way is every time doing the buffer search, you take one element out from the q, right? The other way is you take everything out of the q, right? What's the difference? Look, all right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so let's simulate this, and then that's 6, 7. Okay. First of all, you put the what in. Look, you put the what in.
We put everything.
1. Okay. Hmm. Okay, you take 1 now, right? Now you have 2 choices. You can push, you take a 1 out, right? You take a 1 out, and then you need to push 2 and 3 in, okay? Okay, now you have 2 choices. Is you take a 2 out, and you push the 4 and 5 at the end. Or, you take a 2 and 3 out, and then you push their kids, which is 4, 5, 6, 7. You see the difference? If you take everything out of the queue, it means that every time you're traveling level by level, and then we don't need this level thing again, right? Because you can do have a level here, level equals 0. Every time when you do it, you level plus equal 1, right? Because every time you take every node in the queue, because they are all in the same level, and you take it out, and you expand the kids 4, 5, 6, 7, and they, every time all the nodes in the queue belongs to the same level, okay? So if we do this way, let's do this first, okay? Do num 0, and then we can expand it. So we can do what? We can, first of all, we get a length, okay? Let's say the t equals length q, okay? So this is the number of the nodes in a q, in the same level, and then I need to expand it for in range t, First of all, I need to get it, right? I need to get what? The current node, its parent, and then its level. Level will be equals Q dot. How do we get the number from? How do we pop it from the queue?
Pop
left. Yeah, take it from the left side. Yeah. Take it over. And all the logics is the same. First of all, we need to find out if current dot value. Yeah, if current dot value. If it's in, let's think data. Yeah? Data. Remember this data thing. X Y. Right. X Y.
No.
If current of value in data means that we have found x or y, then we need to update it. So which is data current dot value level, yeah, level equals level, parent equals parent, okay? I'm going to write it, okay? Parent equals parent, root of, level equals level. Okay, and then now we need to find out if current dot left, yeah, current dot left. If it has a left kit, we need to append. We need to do what? If they are left kit, we need to do what?
Left kit.
We need to do what? What's the purpose? We take it out. If we push its kit back to the queue, right?
Yeah.
So let's Q dot a what?
A pen,
a tuple, yeah? Luda left. And what's its parent? Come on, what's its parent? What's the parent of Luda left?
Right.
And the level is level plus one, right? Yeah, we already know the level plus one. And this is the same thing for the right, Luda right. If current dot right, if they have right kit, Q dot append, Luda right, Luda. Level plus one, okay? And again, if we find out, look, if we find out, we can put it here, right? So if we find out the data dot x and data dot y, the x and y value has been visited before, it means we already know the parents and levels for x and y, so we don't need to continue, we can just break, right? Am I right? Yeah? Because we already found it, and we can determine if X and Y are cousins. And then the next will be the same, yeah? Return data X level equals data Y level. And data X parent equal or not equal? Not equal, data Y the parent, okay? Yeah? So look, this is the thing we're expanding. So we don't actually need the level, yeah? Because we already know the level. Level plus equals zero at the beginning. And every time, level plus equals one. And then we can just put the level here. Yeah, this level. So this is one way of optimization. Okay? What's the time complexity? It's just the different ways of visiting the trees. So what's the time complexity? If it's different order. If it's different order, the time complexity will be the same, right? So what's the time complexity? Oh, and what's the space complexity? Very obvious here. Are we using any additional space?
Yes.
What, which arrows?
Q.
Yeah. Because when it's expanded, if it's the perfect binary tree, yeah? Perfect binary tree. So you will have this. You have this. This is the linear to the number of nodes. Okay, so in one sentence, what have you learned so far today? Summarize.
Cousins.
What are cousin nodes in binary tree? What are cousin nodes in binary tree?
In the same line, but have different parents.
Yeah, in the same line, but in a different parents. Okay. Ryan, any questions? Alright, Ryan. Where's Ryan?
Ryan,
what are you doing? Okay, that's it for today. Good job.
Bye.
Bye-bye.